All right, let's go now and talk to gonna be Ted from Orlando. Ted, you're on News Talk WDBL. Go ahead.
Yes, good morning. My question is, I'm considering taking a lawyer to small claims court. He represented me in a DUI case. He neglected to inform me of a required court appearance for entering a plea bargain or a plea.
All right.
And he did not show up to request a continuance. He just ignored the date altogether. The judge issued a bench warrant unbeknownst to me. I was arrested coming back into the country by Homeland Security and held for 6 days in Miami-Dade Correctional Institute.
Ow.
And I had someone on my behalf try to get him to have the judge reverse, which the judge agreed but did not sign the waiver of the warrant until it was too late on a Friday. It spent the weekend. It was Monday late afternoon before I got out. Is that grounds for a small claims court?
Well, keeping in mind, what small claims is about, Ted, is that if your claim is under $5,000, the clerks will give you the forms. They will tell you how to pursue your case step by step.
If you're over
$5,000, you can still do it by yourself, but the clerks will not give you the forms. They will not give you any advice.
I would be satisfied with five or less.
Well,
I'm tired of paying attorneys and getting very little results.
Yeah,
and,
my
question is that sufficient ground?
I think we've covered that already, Ted. So, Ted, let's pot Ted up. Ted, are you still with me?
Yes.
So I think your situation is fascinating. It's tragic, but it's fascinating, Ted. But let's talk. First of all, everybody makes mistakes. I've been a lawyer for 30 years. I have made mistakes. And my father was a lawyer, and he taught me a very valuable lesson as a young lawyer. And he says, Tom, I've made mistakes, but I've always managed to fix them. Your lawyer in that case is trying to fix it. It sounds like it, but that does not change the fact that you spent 6 nights in jail, correct?
Correct.
All right. So then the question gets down to be, what is a measure of your damages? I don't know. What would a court award you for that?
I lost pay from work. It was, my employer was notified. It was an embarrassing situation. I had some emotional, trauma associated with it. I had to go to Miami for a day to explain the situation.
Okay. So, Ted, I would say that, Ted, your lost wages, no ifs, and buts, is a measure of your damages. Your emotional distress that's where we get into the gray area of what a court might do for you. Now, Ted, just out of curiosity, have you gone to this attorney and said, look, you have done me wrong. I know you're trying to fix it. Keep on trying to fix it because at least you owe me that. Now, in addition to that, I want you to pay me something or give me some free legal services. Have you approached him about that?
Yes.
And what was his response?
No, wouldn't pay a dime.
Okay. So, Ted.
I barely got an apology.
Yeah, that's a shame, Ted. And by the way, no names, of course, but is this happening right here in Orlando, Orange County?
No.
Ted, I agree that this is a small claims course. I don't know what the measure of damages is going to be at the end of the day. Ted, if you pursue this, if you would call me back when you're finished and report your results, I would love to hear it.
Okay.
All right, Ted.
What do you think the odds are?
I think that there is, in a sense, that you have a measurable measure of damages, your lost wages. There is no doubt that you are going to win that. If that ends up to $1,500, that may be the end of it, but you're going to get your court costs too. But right. Will the judge give you some punitive damages, some emotional distress damages? I would like to think so.
Yeah.
I mean, if the judge is not going to give you emotional damages, then let him go spend 6 days in jail and see what it's like.
Right. I also lost my wallet, clothing. Miami-Dade claimed they gave it back. They did not. I had to go through a new identification. I documented all this to the attorney. I was not after him because of his negligence as much as the actual damages that the situation caused me and some emotional stress.
All right.
I think it's worth something.
So I agree with you, Ted. Okay. I'm so sorry for your experience with this attorney, and best of luck to you. I would love to hear what the outcome of the case is.